Okay, so to close our lightning talk round is Bee, who will be talking about a very interesting way of applying machine learning to community insights. So take it away.
Hi, so I'm Bee. I work with Fedora and I'm right now an outreach intern with Mozilla. So I mostly work with community related stuff in Fedora, and I am very passionate about machine learning and NLP, and because I studied computer science and I want to use it to understand the community. So this is sort of a pet project for me, because I saw that like whenever I wanted to do any wiki gardening task, it took me a lot of time. Like, I don't know. I mean, Fedora has a very big wiki and it has too much redundant information, and it was hard for me to find the correct pages to identify like how to do wiki gardening or what I could do, and if I wanted some information like which page was the correct one, which one had the updated information and so on. So I have basically identified three main categories where I could use big data and NLP to aid search wiki gardening tasks. So the slides are just very concise, but you can find some code I have written here. I'm still developing it because Fedora Wiki is too large, and I'm thinking of using some parallel processing to access the pages simultaneously, but I have not worked on that yet. So the first problem, I think, which is very common, is that like if you have a large wiki for your project, then I don't know, it just grows on, and there is a lot of redundant information there. So, I mean, there may be two pages which will have the same information, and I don't know, it is one of the wiki gardening tasks for contributors, so that to identify such pages so that they can be merged. So, for that, what I suggest is that you can use, we can use text similarity from NLP. I hope you all know NLP. I don't have to explain what NLP is. Can you just raise your hands if you don't know what NLP is? Okay, so NLP is basically natural language processing. So what it does is you try to process the textual information. So it can do it in two ways. One is it just takes the words, and then it has some, it doesn't understand the information actually, it just processes the text. So you can just take the words, and then you can have a bag of words model, like you can mix the words and just match the words or the characters or the alphabets, whatever. And the second is semantic similarity, which is a bit tough, where you try to understand what the words actually mean, and then you try to get information out of that. So in the first one, I haven't done anything related to semantic similarity. I mean, I do not try to grasp what it actually means, but when there is redundant information, I have seen a pattern that mostly the common words are used everywhere. So if you just compare, if you use a text similarity function from, say, gensim in Python, and you compare two pages, you will, for highly redundant information between two pages, you'll get a high text similarity score. In Fedora Wiki, I found that for some pages, there was a similarity score as high as 85%, and I was like literally shocked. So you could do this, and you can start doing this. Like, you can first implement it at a category-wise level. So it is a bit easier to run. The program doesn't keep on running for too long. And you don't need to write the text similarity functions on your own. You can use inbuilt functions in Python libraries. Gensim is one, NLTK is another. Or if you prefer any other language, then you can. Like, I mostly work with Python, so I'm suggesting those. So the second one is identifying old pages which need to be like updated or which are out of date. So every wiki has a sort of edit history. So it is pretty easy to write a script just to check when the page has been last updated, and say if the pages have been not been updated in, say, the past X months or so, then maybe we need to give a closer look to those pages. So, like, in case of Fedora, I put the barrier of X at 12 months, so that would be a year. And I checked, like, if the pages have not been updated, so what do I do? Obviously, this would also depend on the category of the pages you are looking for. So, say it's an event and it's you are just using it wiki as an archive for those events, then maybe you do not need to check for that category because it's just an archive. But if it is a wiki about, say, some meeting or some project information, so or some team, then maybe, yes, you need to check it and see if it has been really old and does it have any out-of-date information. So, like, if you just put a filter on the edit history if and write a script for that, then you can easily get a list of such pages. And so the third thing is, third is, like, how can you categorize these pages, like, automatically? So this is a very big NLP and machine learning problem about categorization. So, I mean, I cannot say that this is one algorithm you can do because everybody tries it. But what I'm trying to say is that maybe you could find a balance between humans and, say, big data things. So maybe you can use some classification algorithm based on machine learning by giving, say, inputs from previous, giving a training set based on what types of pages are in a particular category, and then it can suggest a new category automatically for the new page, and then maybe some person can verify it. I mean, it would be easier. I mean, it's better than having no category at all for the page. So these are some common problems and how you could do it. And if you want to see the detailed code, it's on the GitHub link there. And you can develop it for your own wiki. It's not really that tough to write. I mean, it just requires some knowledge of Python and I don't know. NLP is not really tough and it already has inbuilt functions, so you can use them. And Jensen has some pretty good documentation. And NLTK has some great documentation too. So if you have any questions on how to develop this, but I am ready to answer them. I mainly wanted this to be a Q&A session so that I could answer your queries more so.
Yep. All right. Yeah. Thank you so much. So, any questions? We actually have about 5 minutes left, so any questions? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What kind of results have you seen from running this on the Fedora Wiki?
Yeah, so I ran this thing on different categories. I ran it first, the first thing category-wise. So I saw that most of the information in some particular categories was two pages had very high similarity score for them. So I could identify those pages easily. So I put a filter, say if you have a similarity score above 0.75, then I wanted a list of all those pairs of pages. So I could get those URLs and then I could see, yes, maybe these have same common information, and then I merge them manually.
So how much compression of the wiki, or how much savings were you able to achieve with that then? Did you find it was very common or not common at all?
No, it was very common, at least in Fedora Wiki, because Fedora Wiki is really, really large. Like, it has millions of pages, indexes, and it's really hard to find any new information or whatever I'm looking for in it. Like, even if I just search for something, it gives me a long list of pages, and that's not necessarily the page I'm looking for. I have to go through everything always. So it really compressed it a lot, but still there's a lot of work to be done. I cannot give you an exact score because I did not go on merging everything.
Sure. Thanks.
Anything else?
Is there a lot of work to get rid of the wiki markup to just get the text?
For Fedora Wiki, no. Oh, so you are just saying the wiki markup, right? No. So you can use Beautiful Soup and other libraries to get the text directly out of it, and they have functions. So that it's really easy. There wasn't really much work for me to get text from the page.
Sure, yeah.
So, and Beautiful Soup is really good. Like, I would recommend it just to get the text.
All right, and I guess we need to move people in and out. So that, thank you so much once again. And if anybody wants to ask any other questions, you know, you can find me.
I'll be at Fedora booth. So if you want to ask any questions, I'll be there and I can answer your questions then.